As soon as you hear the words weapon and science fiction, you'll probably imagine lasers, bright, intense beams of light that can cut through metal and destroy anything in their path. That's exactly what we're talking about today, a laser weapon. Laser weaponry has been a dream of military engineers since the mid-20th century, but only in recent years has it become practical for real-world use. This explains why only a handful of countries in the world possess such advanced technology. And now, Ukraine has joined this exclusive club. According to Colonel Vadim Sukarevsky, the commander of the recently formed Unmanned Systems Forces, Ukraine is the fifth country to possess such a laser. Sukarevsky is also the reason we even know about this remarkable achievement, as he revealed its existence at the European Defense Industry Prospects for Cooperation with the Ukrainian Defense Industry Conference on December 16, 2024. His words left no room for doubt. It really works. It really exists. But what is this "it" Sukarevsky refers to? He's referring to a laser-directed energy weapon, or LDEW, called Trizub. Translated from Ukrainian, the name of this weapon means trident, which is also Ukraine's national symbol. There's a trizub on the Ukrainian coat of arms, and now there will be a trizub in the skies, defending the land, the people, and the very spirit of Ukraine. Ukraine, ever the innovator, has developed one of the most cutting-edge laser systems in existence. It's capable of shooting down aircraft at altitudes exceeding 1.24 miles, a game-changer for air defense. And the best part, the laser is already operational, with plans to scale up its capabilities. That's the good news. The bad news, at least for this video, is that the specifics of its development and deployment remain classified. We don't know its full capabilities, where it's been stationed, or how widely it's been distributed. However, we can make a few educated guesses based on what experts have been saying about the weapon. For starters, the name of the weapon and its strong symbolism gives us a significant clue. It suggests that the weapon is likely domestically built, further underlining the country's growing prowess in military technology. The only concrete figure we know for sure is the range, 1.24 miles. But beyond this, much remains unclear, for now. Patrick Senft, an expert with Armament Research Services, explained to CNN that while details are scarce, it's entirely feasible for Ukraine to develop a functional directed energy weapon capable of destroying some aerial targets. He suggests the system could be built using commercial off-the-shelf welding lasers combined with other technologies, similar to systems used by other nations. Speaking of systems used by other nations, they are the ones that will give us a clearer picture of what Trizub is capable of. More specifically, the Trizub laser is thought to be modeled on a UK prototype, with designs shared with Kyiv earlier in 2024. Before the unveiling of Trizub, there was talk of supplying Ukraine with this UK-developed laser weapon, the DragonFire. Former UK Defence Secretary Grant Shapps suggested that DragonFire could have huge ramifications for the conflict, especially as Russia ramped up its use of attack drones. However, as former British Armed Forces Minister Leo Doherty pointed out, DragonFire was still a few years from being operational. Its full capabilities are not expected until 2027. Despite this delay, the sharing of the DragonFire designs likely gave Ukraine a significant push to develop its own laser systems. Some experts now believe that instead of waiting for DragonFire's completion, Ukraine used this opportunity to fast-track its own version. With Trizub already operational, it's clear that Ukraine has taken the designs and gone above and beyond to create this powerful directed energy weapon. However, according to Ukraine's military and defense portal, Defense Express, DragonFire isn't the only laser weapon Trizub bears similarities to. It also resembles the US Navy's laser weapon system, or LAWS. With this in mind, let's see what the two laser systems could tell us about Trizub's power, range, and accuracy. The DragonFire system is a cutting-edge, high-energy laser weapon designed to disable or destroy a range of targets, from drones to missiles. Although still in development, DragonFire has demonstrated several impressive technical specifications that could offer some clues about the capabilities of Trizub. First up, the power output. DragonFire's peak power output reaches up to 50 kilowatts, a figure that places it firmly in the realm of high-energy laser systems. This kind of power allows it to target fast-moving threats like drones and missiles with devastating precision, sending out concentrated beams of energy that can disable or destroy the target. The LAWS system, on the other hand, is capable of operating with a maximum power output of up to 30 kilowatts. While this is less than DragonFire's, it still represents a significant amount of energy, capable of neutralizing lighter, faster-moving threats such as unmanned aerial vehicles and small boats. LAWS demonstrated its effectiveness during field tests, showing its ability to engage and destroy targets despite having a lower power rating. As for Trizub, it likely operates within the same power range, 30 to 50 kilowatts. This power output makes it an ideal candidate for defense against the kinds of missile and drone attacks that have become commonplace in modern warfare. Next, let's consider range. While the exact range of DragonFire remains classified, it's known to have engaged targets at distances of up to 2.1 miles during its high-power trials. LAWS trails behind in this aspect as well. having demonstrated an effective range of roughly 1 mile. These two figures suggest that TriZub's reported range of 1.24 miles is very much within reach. This range is more than sufficient to target fast-moving aerial threats like drones, as well as some types of missile or aircraft. It's also a significant improvement over earlier systems with shorter ranges, proving that TriZub could be quite effective against threats at a moderate distance, without the need for extreme proximity to the target. Then there's the accuracy. DragonFire has been demonstrated to hit a target the size of a US quarter from roughly 0.62 miles away, which is a level of precision that would be difficult to achieve with traditional munitions. Though Laws hasn't quite earned the title of coin shooter yet, it still packs a punch in terms of accuracy. Its maximum precision is typically measured in the range of small, unmanned aerial vehicles or low-flying threats such as Scan Eagle UAVs. TriZub's accuracy would likely need to meet or exceed this standard, especially in operations where the margin for error is razor thin. Whether engaging drones, missiles, or other fast-moving targets, the ability to strike with such precision would ensure that TriZub could neutralize threats without causing unnecessary collateral damage. This would make it an invaluable tool in environments where urban warfare or civilian proximity is a concern, as it is in Ukraine, offering both lethality and restraint. Another aspect we must discuss is flexibility and operational versatility. DragonFire has been successfully integrated onto mobile platforms like the Wolfhound armored vehicle. This means that the weapon could be rapidly repositioned to address new threats as they emerge. Since the Laws was developed by the US Navy, it shouldn't be surprising that the laser system was deployed aboard an amphibious transport ship, the USS Ponce, during its trials. There, it tested against a wide variety of threats in the Arabian Gulf. The ability of these weapons to operate in such mobile, dynamic environments speaks to the potential for TriZub to also be deployed on a range of platforms. This flexibility could be vital for Ukraine, where the ability to quickly adapt to changing threats and move defensive assets as necessary could tip the balance in its favor. Finally, there's the cost-effectiveness. DragonFire, with its impressive performance, remains surprisingly affordable. Each shot costs approximately $13, making it a cost-efficient alternative to traditional munitions, which can quickly add up in both financial and logistical terms. This efficiency could be a game-changer, allowing forces to engage threats without worrying about expensive munitions, a luxury that traditional air defense systems simply can't offer. Firing Laws, however, comes with a higher price tag in terms of operational expenses. This $150 million system comes with operational expenses that average around $20,000 per hour, which includes costs for maintenance, crew training, and other logistical requirements. However, when compared to the ongoing costs of traditional air defense systems, the cost of a laser weapon can offer considerable savings in the right context. Plus, Laws has the potential to be significantly more affordable per shot. Matthew Klunder, former chief of naval research, sums it up perfectly. Spending about $1 per shot of a directed energy source that never runs out gives us an alternative to firing costly munitions at inexpensive threats. As for TriZub, its cost per shot will also be far lower compared to missiles used by conventional air defense systems. While TriZub's development is still under wraps, it seems clear that it draws heavily on the lessons learned from DragonFire and Laws. The combination of high-powered lasers with precision tracking and targeting systems offers Ukraine a formidable countermeasure against a range of airborne and surface threats. But what threats are we talking about exactly? One of the most pressing threats Ukraine faces in its ongoing conflict with Russia is the relentless barrage of drones, particularly the Iranian-designed Shahid 136. While Ukrainian forces have developed creative and technically sophisticated solutions to counter these threats, such as hacking the drones to send them back to Russia, these methods aren't sustainable in the long term. The sheer volume of Shahid drones, with Russia now producing over 6,000 annually, means that laser capabilities could offer a more permanent and efficient answer. Still, Ukraine's ability to hack these drones has been a remarkable tactical innovation. By spoofing the drone's satellite coordinates, Ukrainian forces have successfully redirected many of them back toward Russian soil, sometimes even forcing them into neighboring Belarusian airspace. This approach, while impressive, has its limitations. For one, it relies on constant monitoring and quick adaptation, as the drone's flight paths become more complex, making them harder to intercept using traditional means. Also, this technique doesn't work on every drone, and its effectiveness can diminish as Russia improves its drone technology. Of course, relying on these ad hoc solutions also places an enormous strain on Ukrainian military resources, both in terms of personnel and technology. A solution like TriZub could drastically reduce the need for such creative fixes and offer a far more reliable, cost-effective, and scalable means to deal with the ever-growing drone threat. With TriZub in play, Ukraine could employ a system designed specifically to deal with the drone menace at a fraction of the cost of conventional anti-air systems. The TriZub's high-powered laser would allow for rapid engagement of drones, whether they're flying in swarms or coming in one at a time. This engagement would render them useless by focusing energy on their delicate components and overheating them. But speed isn't the only thing impressive about Trizub. This laser system also has an infinite magazine. This means that the lasers can continue firing as long as there's available power, as opposed to conventional missile systems that rely on finite ammunition. As a result, Trizub can neutralize a virtually endless number of drones without worrying about running out of missiles or exhausting air defense stocks. Given the sheer volume of Shahed drones being launched daily, up to 80 at a time, this capability could significantly bolster Ukraine's ability to defend its airspace in real time. Trizub's precision, combined with its ability to engage multiple threats simultaneously, would also provide Ukraine with a robust countermeasure against increasingly complex trajectories the Russian drones have been using to evade interception. With Trizub, Ukraine could neutralize drones before they even have a chance to adjust their course. With the added advantage of scalability and precision, Trizub could be a key asset for Ukraine, not only dealing with the Shahed drones, but also in preparing for other future threats, including Russia's hypersonic missiles. These missiles have recently been all over the news, with Russian President Vladimir Putin boasting about the supposed capabilities of the Oreshnik intermediate-range ballistic missile. While this missile can reportedly travel at speeds of up to Mach 10, a staggering 7,000 miles per hour, most Russian hypersonic missiles are not as fast. They typically travel between speeds of Mach 5 and Mach 8, which doesn't make them any less threatening. Thanks to these mind-boggling speeds, these missiles can evade traditional missile defense systems, which rely on interceptors designed to counter slower, less agile targets. The Trizub laser system, however, doesn't require any expensive physical interceptors. It just uses lasers, and lasers operate at the speed of light. This enables the Trizub to engage hypersonic missiles in a way no conventional system can, focusing on precision rather than brute force. Unlike traditional systems that may struggle with the agility and velocity of hypersonic weapons, the Trizub's ability to track and destroy targets almost instantaneously offers a game-changing defense mechanism. If successfully deployed, it could become a cornerstone of Ukraine's strategy to safeguard its skies against the next generation of missile threats. Of course, this means that targets like traditional aircraft, manned fighter jets, would pose no challenge to Trizub. These jets, even the most advanced among them, simply can't outpace or outmaneuver a laser. Whether dealing with low-flying drones or high-altitude bombers, the Trizub can lock onto and neutralize targets with unmatched efficiency and minimal cost per engagement. But don't let the efficiency of laser weapons like Trizub fool you. These systems aren't without their limitations. For instance, lasers lose their potency as they travel over long distances. The further the target, the less energy the beam retains. This means that in an open battlefield, atmospheric conditions such as rain, clouds, and dust can absorb or scatter the laser's energy, reducing its effectiveness. Even worse, there's the phenomenon of thermal blooming, where the surrounding air becomes superheated, causing the laser to spread out and lose power. Fabian Hoffman from the Oslo Nuclear Project emphasizes that these factors could make lasers less effective, particularly in adverse weather conditions. But remember, this technology is still relatively new. As it continues to improve, it's possible that some of these limitations could be mitigated, potentially transforming how wars are fought in the future. And these obstacles certainly aren't slowing down any global progress in directed energy weaponry. In fact, nations are racing ahead, developing and deploying laser technologies that offer immense strategic advantages. Take Israel's Iron Beam laser system, which has completed years of testing and is set for field deployment soon, as an example. The system is designed to neutralize short-range rockets, artillery, and UAVs using a fiber laser with a range of 4.35 miles. The Iron Beam allows Israel to complement its Iron Dome system, offering a more cost-effective alternative for intercepting threats. The US has also made strides, and we aren't talking about the laws. A newer 60-kilowatt version called Helios is being developed as we speak, designed for destroyer-class ships. China, with its deep investment in laser weapons, has also been accelerating its development, while Germany's arms manufacturer Rheinmetall is refining its high-energy laser systems to protect against drones, missiles, and artillery shells, further showcasing laser's potential in modern warfare. But what about Russia? Well, Ukraine's invader has also claimed to possess an advanced laser weapon called the Peresvet. According to official statements, the Peresvet is designed for air defense and anti-satellite warfare, supposedly capable of blinding satellites in low Earth orbit during their flyby. Peresvet, or its advanced version to be precise, was even supposedly used against Ukraine. In May 2022, Yuri Borisov, deputy prime minister at the time, announced the deployment of an advanced laser system called Zadira. Borisov claimed that Zadira could incinerate targets up to 3 miles away within 5 seconds and physically destroy objects instead of merely blinding them. He also boasted about its ability to blind satellites up to 932 miles away. However, these assertions were met with skepticism. The Pentagon stated there was no evidence to support such claims, and Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky dismissed the announcement as propaganda, likening it to the mythic Wunderwaffe touted by Nazi Germany during World War II. All of these developments, real or made up, clearly show that the leading military nations around the world are betting on lasers. Simply put, these weapons are seen as an indispensable tool in the defense of the future. But let's bring us back to the present for a second. What do you think these weapons, Trizub in particular, will do for Ukraine now? Will they help reshape the battlefield dynamics? Also, do you think Russia will respond by accelerating its own development of laser technologies, or will it double down on hypersonic missiles? Share your predictions in the comment section below. Now go and check out this Ukrainian homemade weapon could end the war. Or click this other video instead.